Sassy seems to be the word.
Sassy always seems to be the word. Yeah.
She's small, but she's got a lot of attitude.
Yeah.
She's happy. She's 4 years old, and I can count on one hand how many times I've actually seen her cry.
Carter is just always happy. You look at him and you're happy too, and that's what's really cool. He loves that kind of thrill. Almost even just like the hanging upside down, he loves just that blood rush.
he loves roughhousing.
Yes, and roughhousing and wrestling. He absolutely loves being around his peers, his classmates, his friends, his brothers, family. You'll say his name and he looks at you, or he smiles, or he hears his brothers giggling and it makes him happy too.
I think it was like one in every, was it 2,000 births? Yeah. I think was the percentage that we were told.
And then even more rare that she's four.
Yeah, because it's a very slim chance to make it to your first birthday, and then it gets another percentage around your fifth birthday.
Carter actually does have most of the bones that are in a normal arm, but his forearm is extremely shortened to the point where it basically looks like his hands are attached to his elbows, and his hands are pointed.
Loves his bouncer. He absolutely loves being in that and being able to just to maneuver around the house, whether that's in his gait trainer or on the floor scooting. He gets to where he wants to go.
She definitely has her own personality.
She's very independent for...
That's my favorite thing about her. Haley's least favorite thing about her. She's what we call a touch me not.
A touch me not.
This right here is where she thrives. She'll get loud and she gets real excited and stuff like that around certain people. And as soon as grandma and grandpa or, you know, anybody walks in the room, she just smiles.
And
she,
now it's just not a smile. It's if she's in or something she doesn't want to do, like I'll have her in her high chair, I'll have her in her wheelchair.
She knows how to work grandma and grandpa
and they're
get
like,
her out.
Oh, what do you want me? I'm like, I just put her in there. No, she does not need it. And then they walk out and she's fine. And I'm like, so now we work it more than a smile, don't you?
With all the stuff she goes through, that how much harder it would be if she was like irritable and like always, you know, just yelling and screaming all the time and not happy, like stuff like that. Like how much easier it is knowing that like when she wakes up, like there's a smile on her face.
I am probably most proud of him for what he has taught myself and everybody else about life. That no days given to you, don't take anything for granted.
The joys and the blessings and the positives outweigh the struggle or the things that are more difficult 10 times over. Carter makes everyone a better person. And we've heard that a lot. Is that having Carter in our lives and other people's lives, them getting to know him is a blessing.
At Go Shout Love, we do amazing things for amazing families with kids on rare medical journeys. Each month we shout love for families through the sale of creative apparel inspired by the kids. This month's Built for Life design is inspired by Charlotte and Carter, whose families were both told by doctors that their children were incompatible with life. But thankfully, that message was never received by Charlotte and Carter, as they've battled through incredible odds to bring joy to everyone they meet. Every purchase in September will go toward helping Charlotte's home be remodeled with a more accessible bathroom and the purchase of an adaptive stroller for Carter. Visit our website at goshout.love to support Charlotte and Carter through the purchase of a t-shirt, hat, tank top, hoodie, or other items.
So, you know, we're sharing your month with Charlotte, who is four.
Mm-hmm.
So she's about halfway to Carter.
Mm-hmm.
So if you could tell her the biggest thing that you've learned in your 10 years with Carter, what would you tell her?
Nothing is impossible. Nothing.
It's such a simple phrase, but it's so powerful when you really stop and think
for sure
about it.
You know, nothing is impossible. If you want to go take that family trip, do it. If you want to do additional therapy because you think that it will help them, do that. Whatever you can dream or imagine, it is possible.
Find people who are going to support you. Like, go out and you can find people who understand, but actually reach out to the actual, like, families. Like, find families who have gone through it or are going through it because they know what's going on. They know what's happening. And obviously, it doesn't always end up like Charlotte, but there are families out there who can help you with that, too. Yeah, don't Google. That's the biggest thing. I know it's like the first thing you want to do is look everything up, but the first thing I would say is go on like Instagram, Facebook, so any social media and just type in like try something.